And God bless us, everyone. Hey everyone, welcome to the ranking. Here's my ranking of all the Christmas Carol movies. Yes, I'm continuing on with my Christmas themed videos, and this one, I thought this would be an interesting ranking because A Christmas Carol or Scrooge, or Christmas Carol, that's what it's originally called, based off the Charles Dickens novel, A Christmas Carol is such a beloved story about Ebenezer Scrooge getting haunted by three ghosts just to show him the will of how to be a good person and how to respect Christmas and stuff. Everyone knows the story of A Christmas Carol. There is like a gazillion movies about A Christmas Carol and stuff, and it was really hard to do a ranking of this because there's like 40 movies and stuff. There's a lot of straight to DVD ones, a lot of TV movies and specials. There's a lot of just movies in general about A Christmas Carol stuff, so I can't do every adaptation of A Christmas Carol. I can only do the ones I've seen. So I've seen 11 adaptations of A Christmas Carol, so those are the ones that I'm going to do. One of them, Some people will say that doesn't count, but still, I'm going to count anyways. These 11 films I've seen, this is the Christmas Carol movies that I've personally watched and stuff, and most of them are the popular ones that most people have seen, but some of them I bet a lot of people haven't heard of, some for good reason, but yeah, let's not waste any more time. Here's my ranking of the Christmas Carol movies from my least favorite to my favorite, so let's get started. Coming at number 11 is Christmas Carol the movie, the animated movie. Yes, this movie came out in 2001, and this movie has Nicolas Cage and Kate Winslet and other actors, and this movie is absolute garbage. This is an ugly animated film. It doesn't have the Christmas spirit or the Christmas joy, and I just didn't find any enjoyment out of it, and just out of all the Christmas Carol stories, it felt like the least loyal of the adaptations and stuff, and I highly did Ebenezer Scrooge was not really well done. Again, the animation was ugly and cheap looking. It had no Christmas joy or Christmas spirit and stuff. The ghosts don't even look that good or anything. There's nothing even funny or there's not even a really good message to it. It's like the same pandering message as most of them. There's nothing new or different or unique about it. It's just a very ugly kids movie, and yeah, it's one of the worst adaptations of A Christmas Carol I've ever watched, and it's awful. Coming number 10 is A Christmas Carol 1999. This is the one with Patrick Stewart. This was another, I think, TV movie and stuff. This one, again, was not good. Patrick Stewart does give his all in the film, and I give him that, but it's still not really well. It's very clunky. A lot of the supporting cast gives some very hokey, very cheesy, very over-the-top acting, especially some of the actors that play the spirits. Very hokey acting, and I don't know, just everything about it just felt kind of, you know, been there, done that. There's nothing, again, there was no distinct style about this movie. It just felt like another Christmas Carol movie with some really bad acting, with the exception of Patrick Stewart. That's the only thing this movie gets. Patrick Stewart is enjoyable, but everything else, not so much. Coming number 9 is Scrooge 1970. This is with Albert Finney is in this movie, and just like what I said with Patrick Stewart, that's the only reason to watch this movie is Albert Finney. Albert Finney is really good as Ebenezer Scrooge. He does the grumpy scenes really well, like when he's doing the bah humbug and stuff and, like, you know, telling people off and being a complete asshole. Albert Finney's great at that. But anytime he has to show, like, too much fear, just, I didn't buy it. And even when he turns good at the ending, I didn't buy it and stuff. I bought him as the asshole, but not as the nice guy and stuff. And everything else, it kind of just looked cheap looking, this movie. Again, I didn't like the look of the spirits and stuff, especially the ghosts of Christmas Yet to Come. I don't like how they did it in this movie. And I don't know, just, again, it feels like I've been there, done that. There's no distinct style or just nothing remotely enjoyable about this Christmas Carol adaptation. There's a lot of good ones, but just not. This one is the one I tend to avoid every Christmas like the other ones. And yeah, not a big fan of it. Coming number 8 is A Christmas Carol 2009. This is the one with Jim Carrey. This one I do enjoy. This one I like. Yeah, we went from I don't like to like. Yeah, there's none I find just okay. Just I don't like those ones. These ones, all these ones now, I enjoy all these versions of A Christmas Carol. This is the Jim Carrey one. I thought Jim Carrey was really good. I liked how he did all the voices of the ghosts, Jacob Marley, and Ebenezer Scrooge, and he did a very good job. The animation, the stop motion animation, was really well done. Zemeckis directed this movie, did a very good job. It has that Christmas spirit, the Christmas colors and stuff. I did like the ghosts. I didn't like Ghost of Christmas Past because all he does is whisper the whole time. It was kind of annoying. But the present ghost and yet to come was really well done. Again, Scrooge was done very well. I love they got Colin Firth in the movie as his nephew. He was really good. Gary Oldman as Bob Cratchit was really good. And yeah, there was a lot of really good voice acting in this movie. And I, a lot of nice, cool colors and stuff. Vibrant colors, Christmas colors in the movie. There were some scenes that were done really, really well. Like that scene when he has to look Bob Cratchit in the face. Really, really compelling scene. I don't like how they did how the Ghost of Christmas Past, not Past, Christmas Present, how he disappears and how he like turns into a skeleton and stuff. That was weird and made no sense and everything. And yeah, there's a few scenes that do tend to drag a bit. And I'm just like, oh, okay, keep going. You know, let's get the story going and stuff. But I think as a whole, it's still a really good adaptation, and I do enjoy it. I do pop it on every Christmas and have fun with it, and yeah, I do like it. Coming number 7 is A Christmas Carol 1938. This is with Reginald Owen as Ebenezer Scrooge. This is the classic black and white version of A Christmas Carol. Really good, really good, very atmospheric, very bleak. Reginald Owen is absolutely great as Ebenezer Scrooge. Again, it is a lower budget because this is being the 30s and stuff. They didn't have the high-end effects and everything. But for what they have, I think the spirits are done really well. I like how they did The Ghost of Christmas Past. That was really good. How they did the backstory a little differently in this movie was really good. And I thought it was a really good, loyal adaptation. It has the atmosphere and has the good performances. That's what puts it on the edge for me. And yeah, it's not as good as the other ones that I'm about to name, but it's still a really good watch. Coming number 6 is Scrooge 1951. This is with Alistair Sim. This is a damn good film. Again, a lot of it has to do with Alistair Sim. Alistair Sim is probably one of my favorite Ebenezer Scrooge. My second favorite probably at all. He is so good in this movie, Alistair Sim. He is amazing in this film. How he does the grumpy Scrooge and how he turns the tide and becomes a nice guy. Completely bought it. He does an amazing job in this film. It's also a very beautifully shot film. You know, it's a black and white film, how they show the snow and all the Christmas trees and stuff. They do it very well, and the cinematography in this movie is really good. And there is some, this is probably one of the creepiest movies. They show some very brutal and creepy and almost frightening imagery in this film, and it's done extremely well. I'm like, oh my God, Jesus. Especially the scene with Jacob Marley coming and with all the spirits and stuff. That was insane and really intense and stuff. And just, ooh, I'm like, oh my God, I'm a little unnerved right now. The only problem I have with this movie is it's like I said with some of the Christmas, with the Jim Carrey one, I said it, you know, it drags a bit. This one doesn't drag enough. I feel like this movie was rushed too much. How they did his past, they kind of like skimmed through it a little too quickly, and even how they did some of the scenes with the Christmas present, I felt like they could add more scenes with Bob Cratchit and stuff, and I felt like the movie was rushed, and I didn't like that. Other than that, this movie's fantastic, but it's just a tad rushed. And if they just, you know, added a few extra scenes with more Bob Cratchit and more of the backstory of Scrooge, this could have been one of the best ones, but As it is, it's still a great film and definitely one of my favorites. Coming number 5 is Scrooged. Scrooged with Bill Murray. This is fantastic, this movie. This is directed by Richard Donner, and Bill Murray is amazing in this film. This is not the traditional Christmas Carol story and stuff. This is just Bill Murray's an asshole boss and stuff, and his company is doing like a TV program of A Christmas Carol, but during this time, he does get visited by 3 ghosts and stuff, and his old boss is kind of like that Jacob Marley and stuff, and his assistant is like Bob Cratchit and everything, and they dive into this character of this past, present, and yet to come, and the way they do it, it's so different. That's why I love this movie. It's different. It's more different than almost every Christmas Carol movie because it's not a straight A Christmas Carol adaptation. It's a Scrooged adaptation. It's way different. It's much more comical. It's got great slapstick, great Bill Murray one-liners and stuff, and how they do, again, both the Ghost of Christmas Past, Present, and Yet to Come is way different and stuff, and it's got a unique style to it. There are some really dark moments, and Bill Murray's speech at the ending on the television program is just such an uplifting speech, and yeah, I adore this film. There are a lot of flaws with it, but I don't care. I love this. I watch this every Christmas, and it's just so good. Coming number four is The Man Who Invented Christmas. Yes, I'll leave a link down below. I don't need to talk too much about this movie. I did a whole review of it. I love this movie. This movie's not strictly about A Christmas Carol. This is about Charles Dickens coming up with the idea of A Christmas Carol. Dan Stevens plays Charles Dickens. He's fantastic. You got Christopher Plummer in this movie. A lot of great actors. Great production. Great cinematography. It's a great period piece movie. Again, I'll leave a link down below if you want to know my whole opinions on it. But I love this movie. It's definitely one of my favorite versions of A Christmas Carol. Coming number three is Mickey's Christmas Carol. Yeah, Mickey's Christmas Carol. This is so damn awesome. This is like only like a 40-minute movie, and it's amazing. It's fantastic. I love this movie. I have a little bit of a bias and nostalgia for it because I grew up with this movie. I think this is actually the first Christmas Carol movie I ever saw, because I saw this when I was like really young. I think I was like 3 or 4 when I first watched this. And I've been watching it ever since, every year. I love Mickey's Christmas Carol. I love the atmosphere of it. And it's very mature and it's very dark. And this is a straight like kids movie, and it's so good. It's Mickey Mouse. It's Goofy. It's Donald Duck. It's all of them, and it's amazing. Yeah, like, it's so good. You got all the like classic Disney characters in this movie, and it's awesome. I love this movie. I love how they treat Ebenezer Scrooge. I love Mickey in this movie. Mickey's so great. Seeing Mickey in this different sort of story is just, it's different, but it's awesome. I love everything about this movie. The animation, the atmosphere, the uplifting message, and just such a great, touching, heartwarming story, and yeah, definitely one of my favorite versions of A Christmas Carol. It's a bit, it's got a bit of nostalgia link to it, which is not really fair, but yeah, well, I love it. Coming number two is The Muppets Christmas Carol. Everyone knew this was coming. I love this movie. I've talked about this movie a lot. I adore it. Michael Caine as Ebenezer Scrooge was so good. You got Kermit the Frog as Bob Cratchit. You got like Gonzo narrating everything and breaking the fourth wall constantly. Great. So freaking awesome. How they did Jacob Marley in this was hilarious. And this is just a hilarious movie. It's a Muppets movie. I love the Muppets. It's not like my favorite Muppets movie. It's not like the classic Muppets, or it's not like the 2011 movie, but this is probably my third favorite Muppets movie. I love it. I think this movie is hilarious. It's got great musical numbers. It's got great Christmas spirit. How they did it was so really good. There's dark moments. There's light moments. There's silly, goofy moments. A lot of breaking the fourth wall jokes because it's the Muppets. You gotta have that. And just, I love it. It's just so great. If you love the Muppets, you can definitely understand why. But if you don't, I still think you can like this movie, have a lot of laughs with it. And yeah, it's still a loyal adaptation, but it's just got more comedy in it. It's got more of the Muppet style in it, which I love. And my number one favorite adaptation of A Christmas Carol is, everyone knows, it's the 1984 George C. Scott version of A Christmas Carol. This is the best adaptation, movie adaptation of A Christmas Carol. Hands down, it's the most loyal, it's got the best scenes, it's got the best performances, it's got the more atmosphere, and yeah, everything about it's fantastic. Everything about this movie I love. George C. Scott is incredible. Best Scrooge you'll ever get. He is so freaking amazing. Michael Gough is fantastic in this movie as well. All the actors are great. How they did Bob Cratchit, how they did the nephew, how they did Jacob Marley, all fantastic. So freaking good. All the spirits are really great in this movie. I love the Christmas present spirit. I love how bold and to the point he is. And some of his lines at Ebenezer Scrooge is just fantastic. How they did Tiny Tim was really great. Very adorable kid. Very sad. There's some really sad moments, really dark moments and stuff. Just everything about it, it's fantastic. This movie always puts me in the Christmas spirit and stuff, and I absolutely adore this film. The scene when Ebenezer Scrooge talks to his nephew is one of my favorite scenes in all of Christmas films. It's just such a heartwarming scene. It's just all about family. I absolutely adore it. And Everything about this movie I adore. It's a beautifully directed, beautifully shot, wonderfully acted film, and it's hands down the best Christmas Carol movie I've ever watched. So yeah, that was my ranking of all the Christmas Carol movies from my least favorite to my favorite. So in the comments section below, please tell me, did you agree with this ranking? If not, give me your ranking of all the Christmas Carol movies in your opinion. If you've seen every adaptation, give me your thoughts and opinions on all of them. I have not seen all of them because there's way too many of them. But yeah, give me your thoughts and opinions. Comment below, let me know. And as always, if you like this video, please subscribe to this channel and join the dark side.